you better not cry. You better not pout. I'm telling you why. Santa Claus is coming to town. Little tin horns, little toy drums, rooty toot toots, and rummy tum tums. Santa Claus is coming to town. He sees you when you're sleeping, and he knows when you're away.
He knows if you've been bad or good, so be good for goodness sake. You better watch out.
You better not cry.
You better not pout.
I'm telling you why. Santa Claus is coming.
You mean the big fat man with the long white beard.
He's coming to town.
Hi guys, welcome to Vlogmas Day 8. I am in the process of doing Christmas cards. So, like I said before, if you send us a Christmas card, we'll send you one back.
And us.
Alright, let me get to it. Alright guys, we're back. We're going to do a questionnaire, and then, yeah, we've been pretty much blahing all day, so... What's the first question?
What are 5 of your favorite Christmas specials?
You go first.
Why me?
Okay, I'll go first. I like Frosty. I like Rudolph. Santa Claus is coming to town. Actually, we don't have any others other than, like, I like some of the movies that are on, like, Element and... Hallmark Channel. So how about you?
I like The Santa Claus with Tim Allen. I like The Christmas Carol. I like the original Frosty. I like the original Rudolph. I like Elf. And I enjoy Home Alone 1 and 2.
So, let's see. What's the next one?
What are some of your favorite foods that have been prepared at Christmas?
Usually my top, like, 5 things I like. I like ham, stuffing, corn, green bean casserole, pumpkin pie, and the rolls.
I like the ham. Mashed potatoes and gravy, of course. Broccoli casserole. The rolls. And mac and cheese.
All right, next 5. Our next one. The next 5.
What are some of your favorite traditions?
Well, I know there's some traditions that I've never got into. I've always wanted to do, like, Christmas caroling. I don't know if you've ever thought about doing that.
I've actually Christmas caroled. I didn't enjoy it. I froze my butt off.
Other than that, I only have one. My mom and I, we started putting the Christmas tree up when I was real little, right after we got done eating the Thanksgiving dinner, and that's the only thing I've ever done. As far as tradition-wise, every year. Oh, well, we did do one thing. New Year's Eve, I used to go over to my parents' house and celebrate Christmas because Christmas Eve was actually my father's birthday. And also, when my grandfather was alive, we also would celebrate Christmas Eve as well at the same day because that way cover my mother's side of the family. And then we stayed at home, and then we went to my dad's side of the family on Christmas Day. How about you?
Well, one of the main traditions in my family is the meal. My late mamma, she would always cook this real big thing of dinner. It included all sorts of meat, vegetables, desserts, and everything. And then my mom did the same thing, and all the family would gather at her house. And while my mama, she died in 2005, and my mom just don't do it no more, so I do it. And even though we are, like, hours away from my family, you know, I still have my family, so I still cook that meal, and that is, like, very important to me.
All right.
And another tradition of mine is, sometime before Christmas, I always sit down and like to tell the kids the true meaning of Christmas. That is one thing my mama always did for me, so.
It's my turn now.
Okay.
I'm gonna ask a question.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
What is your most memorable moment at Christmas?
Well, one of them that I hold really dear to my heart is, I was a little kid. Some of you might remember back when snow was like 2-3 cars high, you know, big drifts or whatever. Boy, down in Kentucky, I remember being that big anyway. We would go to, one Christmas we went to my mamaw's and there's snow on the road and everything. It was Christmas Eve and it was one of the last dinners I remember my mamaw cooking before she had her strokes. And it was just a really good time. Everybody showed up and nobody fought, which was the main thing. And then another one was when my sister was born and my mamaw came to our house and brought us a bunch of gifts. And she was a little bitty baby and we had a wood stove and it was a barrel stove. And well, my mom and dad's bed was right by the wood stove, and Mamaw said, "Sharon Dale," she said, "don't lay that baby so close to that stove." She said, "Might catch her on fire or something." She was born a real red baby anyway, and she was red. And Mom said, "Mom, that's just the way she is. That's the way she was born. Still, Sharon Dale, move her away from the wood stove."
Sorry about the furnace, it kicked on.
But yeah, that's a memorable moment. That's yours. You didn't answer.
Yeah, I know. I'm going to answer it now.
Okay.
Goober.
Okay. Just so.
All right, my most memorable, I guess, when I was little, you know, obviously I'd get up Christmas morning, go open the Christmas gifts, and then when we got done, we'd all head over to my grandmother's house. And she had, like, a four-level house, and it was back in the woods, and we'd all get together. I mean, everybody on my dad's side of the family, we would all come over there, and they'll play cards, and all the kids would play, and it was pretty good night. And it was every single Christmas, that and Thanksgiving. We'd always be doing it on Thanksgiving, too. And that was, I think, every morning I'd be looking forward to going over there playing with my cousins and stuff like that. It was a lot of fun. All right, babe, you gonna read the last one?
What are some of the important traditions you want to pass down to the kids?
Well, the only thing that I can think of is maybe one day I can actually get them to do the tree on Thanksgiving. Like I do, like my mom used to. And maybe actually teach them how I usually put it up, because I put it up a certain way.
Well, I would like for one of them to carry on the family gatherings, the meals. And I don't want them to lose the true meaning of Christmas or the fact that Christmas isn't about what you get as much as what you give. And that would be a very important thing that I want them to know.
Yep, sounds like true.
So that's what I want them to know.
All right, you ready to go do the question or the fact of the day?
I think so.
All right, let's go. Or do you want to just go get it and come back?
I just want to go get it and come back.
All right. Kids are being bad. They're screaming and hollering and everything else. All right, what is today's?
Which one of us got on the preschool school bus and came right back off?
Okay. All right, guys. Put your comment down below who you think it is. And if you're new to this channel, please hit the subscribe button down below. We upload every week after Vlogmas, of course. Make sure you like, comment, share, join our family. And we will see you tomorrow. Bye, guys.